What's up everyone, this is ShoryuGame welcoming you to another KOF 15 trailer analysis. I'm happy to announce that all my speculations were wrong so far. This week, we didn't have a trailer for a K-Dash's team member. Heck, we didn't have the kind of trailers that we used to have. This time, we were given our first look into two characters in the same trailer. The Invincible Dragon, Ryo Sakazaki, and the Raging Tiger, Robert Garcia. I mean, I knew that Ryo's reveal wouldn't tarry for long, but I wasn't expecting to see Robert with him at the same time. So, who are these guys? They are the two protagonists of the Art of Fighting series and the only playable characters of its first installment. It's partially thanks to them that KOF was born, as the developers wanted to put them in a dream match game against the cast of Fatal Fury. So saying that they are essential in KOF's roster would be a huge understatement. They've been present in every single game of the series, except for Robert, who was absent in 11 at first, but brought back anyway as an unlockable fighter for its console release. I love how the trailer begins with the retro style with the theme from the original Art of Fighting intro. If you played that game, I'm sure you found it very nostalgic. Then we have our first glance at Ryo. And one thing is certain, he was living at the gym in the last few years. All male characters look more buffed in 15 compared to 14, but Ryo is on a new level on his own. Robert's design, on the other hand, looks pretty much unchanged. He did have a major design update in 14, which I loved a lot, and keeping it for 15 is a good call in my opinion. I like how he flips his coin again during his intro, which was his win pose in previous games. I think these detailed intro animations occurred only for the first matches. Subsequent ones will have simple intros, as we see here just before the gameplay starts. The first attack shown is Robert reverse throwing Ryo. Then he goes for a down B, followed with an overhead forward A, but Ryo interrupts him with a crouch C. Not learning his lesson, Robert goes for the same thing again, but this time, Ryo retaliates with a guard cancel attack, causing Robert to wall bounce and following it with a level 2 super Hao Shokoken. I want to make a brief pause here. What the heck, guard cancel attacks couldn't do a wall bounce before. This is a huge deal. They look extremely powerful in this game. Unless it's not a guard cancel attack, or maybe it has different requirements this time than a simple meter. I'm curious to see how this is going to play. Next, Ryo performs a basic jump CD attack that looks exactly the same as the one he had before. He follows Robert on the ground with a close C, but Robert does a DP which traded with Ryo's attack. Then it's Robert's turn to follow Ryo on the ground with a close C, forward B, which they were both blocked by Ryo, who goes for a sweep that was also blocked by Robert. This water-like effect during the block animation, is it related to the theme of the game? If my speculation is right, the main boss of this game is going to be the second half of Shune's power, the thing that looks like a bluish entity, and if verse is associated with fire, this entity could be associated with water, which can also explain water as the main theme of this game, and why the effect during the blocking animation looks that way. I also want to point the quick white flash on Robert here, which implies that the game could have a just guard mechanic. Maybe if you block an attack just at the right time, you'll build extra meter or have some other kind of reward. We also get to see that Ryo still has his down forward B. After that, he starts attacking with close C, forward A, an EX Hienshi Pokyaku, sending Robert further in the air and allowing him to follow it with a regular Dragon Punch, then an EX Dragon Punch. In the next sequence, Robert initiates a combo with a close C, forward B, and a Hienshi Pokyaku. Ryo tries a down B, crouch C, which were successfully blocked by Robert. Ryo cancels that for a new attack that I've never seen him do it before. It looks like a charge punch. I didn't play Ryo in all KOF games, so maybe he had this move before, but I don't remember I ever saw it. Next combo saw Robert doing a double down B, forward A, and since he becomes airborne, he could follow it with a Hien Ryujin Kyaku. Then both fighters decide to play some zoning games, except that Ryo's fireballs are short-ranged. He gets hit by Robert's regular and EX fireballs. Next, we see Ryo attacking with a jump CD, successfully blocked by Robert. He then backdashes and attacks with an EX Kouoken, which makes Ryo's fireballs long range this time. I believe that wasn't the case in 14. After a simple throw, Robert jump kicks Ryo, continues with a close C, forward B, EX Hienchi Pukyaku, followed with a close C again, cancelled into an EX Genikyaku, and ending it with a dragon punch. I like this combo a lot. Afterwards, Robert attacks with a jump CD and follows Ryo, who interrupts him with an EX DP. Robert then does this weird guard cancel attack, and it becomes clear that it's not actually a guard cancel attack. Ryo doesn't even attack here. So I guess this is a new mechanic of 15 and works kinda like a counter maybe. Perhaps it has its own meter, I don't know. For now, I'll just call it the counter purple CD thing. I'm not good with naming things. Anyway, Ryo blocks it, but Robert surprises him with a VP. Robert then throws a fireball and jump kicks Ryo. However, Ryo does the counter purple CD thing, and you can see that the move goes off before Robert's attack lands, so it's clearly not a guard cancel attack. It works a lot like a counter and allows to start combos. It's noteworthy that this time it doesn't make Robert wall bounce. Is there multiple versions of it? Maybe. Ryo follows it with a close C and forward A. I guess his forward A is still not cancelable into special attacks unless it's an EX version, as we saw earlier. After a basic throw from Ryo, he goes for a close C into his charge-like punch, but Robert intercepts it with the counter purple CD thing that has the advantage here. Ryo's attack seems completely absorbed by it, leaving him vulnerable to Robert's next chain of attacks, starting with a close C, forward B, into his level 2 super, Ryukurambo. Finally, we have a cool look at the two friends performing their level 2 supers, Aushokoken, at the same time, which cancel each other. And at last, they begin the level 3 supers, but sadly, the trailer ends before we get to see more of them. I guess they are no different from their climax supers in 14. There are a lot of reused assets in their moves anyway. And then the big reveal. King is their third teammate, and the Art of Fighting team is finally complete. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting this. We all knew that the Art of Fighting team should be announced very soon, considering how essential of a team it is, but I wasn't expecting it to have this composition of members. Ryo and King in the same team was definitely a possibility, but I thought Yuri was going to be the third member, like KOF 11, but I'm very glad I was wrong. The Art of Fighting team was rearranged and Robert was not sacrificed. The closest thing we had of this version of AOF was in 2000, but Takuma was the fourth member. Having only the three in the same team is a first. And the best thing, it shouldn't be that surprising. We already saw all three of them gathered in a stage that is also present in 15. Were they hinting it all this time since Art of Fighting 2? So that's pretty much confirmed that Yuri and Mai are in the Women Fighters team. We only have to wait to see who is going to be their third teammate. Blue Mary maybe? I love how SNK are handling their character and team reveals so far. With the exception of the Fatal Fury team, they were successful in shattering the expectations, I'd say. That's it for now. I hope that was somewhat informative, if not entertaining. As always, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching.